performing Monkey's Paw, a short story by W.W. Jacobs. I'm sure SCBS students here and in the class 10 is the same story. And this is sort of a serious play. It's a thriller. So I hope that you maintain it such. And also, guys, your phones are ordering, it really like irritates everybody on the stage, no one likes it. So please just put your phones off. And I thank you all for coming out here and showing your support to the theater. The audience is what makes us, you know, come back and perform for you guys semester after semester, and I hope that will keep going on. So thank you all for being here. Starting today's evening event, and have fun.
Peter!
There you go. Sammy, my boy. This should show you.
Oh, he's beat you at last. Has he?
Heck no.
Let me take that back.
That rules of the game, man.
I don't go by these scientific rules. You made an innocent pastime into something.
Father, you talk so much. Look, you put him off now.
No, no, it's not him.
Sammy. Sammy. Yeah. You're that wind.
I'm listening. Check.
I don't suppose Sergeant Morris will come today.
Hey, Dad.
Huh. That's the worst of living so far out. Your friends can't come for a quiet chat. And you scramble your brains over a confounded.
Tom!
Dad. Morris will come tonight, alright?
Of all the beastly, slushy, out of the way places to live in, this has to be the worst. Pathway is a bomb. The road's a torrent. I don't know what the county board are thinking about. Just because it's the only house on the road, they think it doesn't matter.
Never mind, dear. Maybe we'll win the next game.
Ah, there he is.
I wonder what yarn he's got for us tonight.
Awful. Just awful!
And a mile down the road, it's even worse.
So much wind, it'll blow the hair off of him. Goodness gracious, Sergeant, you must be freezing. Please sit by the fire and warm up.
Thank you, boiling.
Ah, sir, how are you? Not at work yet, huh?
This should take care of the chin.
I work the night shift at the electric company. Oh, and by the way, Dad's told me many stories of your crazy adventures.
Has he? I'm sure they've all gotten better over time.
Is it my fault that you've given us so much time to tell them? 21 years, Charlie has been off in the military, witnessing wars, planes, and strange people. I remember him being a young chap, and now, look at him.
Oh, well, he doesn't look like he's taken much harm, except
for... And for that, I got this.
No, ma'am. Tough.
Charlie Morris is tough. A soldier's life for me.
You aren't drinking, sir.
Not a single drop, sir. You see, it's not that I'm unsociable. It's just my work don't go well. I need to keep a steady hand, you see. It's that, or probably the machinery might just gobble me up.
Sammy, don't say such things.
Electricians. Magicians, they are. Light, they say, and light it is.
Beats me, and I've seen everything.
All that Indian magic, it's all fake. The magicians, the fakirs, it's all fake.
Fake, the boy calls it.
I've seen it.
Oh, come on.
You don't believe me, boy.
Now. He's just having a bit of fun. I would like to go to India myself. just to look around a bit, you know.
You're better where you are, Mr. White, trust me.
I'd like to see those old temples, the jugglers, the fakirs. What was that story you were telling me the other day? About a monkey's paw or something, Morris?
Nothing. It's not worth hearing about.
Monkey's paw.
No. Don't talk.
But you said you always carried with you.
I do. The fear of what might happen.
But why? What is it for?
So it's...
You won't believe me.
Come on now, tell us.
It's magic.
Don't laugh.
We aren't laughing, but like, do you have it on you now? Can we see it?
I love it. Wait, it's right here. It's not much to look at. It's an ordinary little paw dried to a mummy.
And what is there so special about it?
Special? Well, it's said that a very holy man, an old fakir, would have cursed it. So that those who meddle with fate suffer. He did this so that three separate men would each have three wishes granted.
Wishes?
And mind you, these three men would have reason to believe that they had never wished.
But how could the wishes be granted?
I really don't know. All I do know is that it would all seem so natural that you could possibly allude it to a coincidence.
Have you tried it yet, sir?
And were your three wishes granted? And has anybody else tried?
So the first man had his three wishes granted.
Oh, he had his three wishes granted, all right.
So I don't know what the first two wishes were. But the third wish, his final wish, was the death. And that's how I got home.
Morris, if you've had your three wishes, what do you keep it for?
This, fancy, I suppose. It's not like I haven't tried to sell it, but I don't think I will. For fear, what might happen? And besides, people think it's a fairy tale. And these others want to buy it. They want to try it first and then pay me later. It's all very futile.
So if you had another three wishes, would you make them?
I don't know.
No!
Let it burn! Let that infernal thing burn!
Morris, if you don't need it, give it to me!
Are you crazy? I threw it on the fire because I'm scared. I'm scared that I don't want to bear the consequences of what might happen. You should throw it back in the fire like a sensible man.
What do you think, Sammy?
Keep it if you must. It's all a bunch of nonsense anyway.
I wonder how you do it.
I can't see you ruin your future, Mr. White.
Oh, come on now, tell us.
Yes, what, Sergeant?
You resist. It's rather simple.
All you have to do is hold it up in your right hand and wish aloud.
That's about it.
Doesn't that sound like the Arabian Nights to you? And dear, if you must wish, you should wish for four pairs of hands of me.
If you must wish, wish for something sensible. I can't take this anymore. I'm leaving.
Morris!
Mr. White, I warn you.
Morris, wait!
Don't worry, Madhav. If his tail of the monkey's paw is anything like his other tail, then we shouldn't have much to worry about.
Hopefully.
Now that we have the paw, I don't know what to wish for.
Dad, you should wish to be an emperor. Because that way, you wouldn't have to be a henpecked husband.
I still don't know what to wish for. It seems I've got everything I want.
Actually, coming to think of it, wouldn't you be happy if you paid off the interest on the house loan? You should wish for £200, Dad.
That is a brilliant idea. And we have nothing to lose, Doc.
Alright then. I wish for 200 pounds. It moved as I wished. It twisted in my hand like a snake.
Dad, I don't see any money. I don't think I'll ever see any money.
Yes, yes, it's very likely that through your family.
Never mind though, no harm done. But it did give me a shock all the same.
Like I said, Dad, no money my way. And it started getting late. The shift starts at midnight.
It is quite late. We should be getting to bed ourselves, honey. Good night, Dami.
Good night, Mother. Oh, and by the way, Dad, let me tell you something. I hope you find all that money that you're looking for tied up in a bag, sitting in the middle of your bed.
And right when you're about to get it,
you should see a monkey sitting on top of that cover, horribly smiling at you, as you try to pocket your ill-gotten gains.
What do you want, my dad?
Morris, I hope he got his train on time.
I know, it was raining cats and dogs last night. But he got to me too.
Well, he's seen worse.
I'm sure. All these old soldiers, they're all the same. Imagine the idea of us listening to his nonsense last night. Wishes, he says.
What's the use?
The cemetery is that way. That's where he buried. He'll never come back home again, Tom.
Come back here. You get cold.
Colder where he lives.
What about it?
I want it. You haven't destroyed it, have you?
It's on the mantle. Why?
I just thought of it. Why did I think of this before? Why didn't you think of this before?
Think of what?
The other two wishes, Tom. You only had one.
Was not that one enough?
We'll have another one. Go. Go quickly. Take the paw and wish our child alive again.
Good God! You're mad!
No, I'm not, Tom! We can have our child alive again! My child!
Go to bed! You have no idea what you're saying!
We had our first wish granted, Tom! But not another one!
A coincidence! Sammy has been dead for 10 days! And besides, he was my son too. I saw his body shattered into pieces. I could only recognize it by the clothing. If it was so difficult then, how can you see him now?
Do you think that I fear the only child I have nursed? No, Tom! Go! Get the paw and wish!
It is foolish and wicked!
Wish!
I wish for my child alive again! Such a request to bring the dead back to life. That thing cannot have the power. Eliza, let's go. Let's go to bed.
No. I mean.
Thank you and good night. I hope you have fun.